intimate, lovely table. Better chairs than the old small council chamber. Conveniently close to your own quarters. I like it.
What news of Jamie? "20,000 unwashed northerners have known about his escape for weeks. Collectively, you control more spies and informants than the rest of the world combined. Do you mean to tell me that none of you has any notion of where he is?"
"We are trying, my lord."
"Try harder. What do we have, then?"
"Robb Stark and most of his bannermen are in Riverrun for the funeral of his grandfather, Lord Hoster Tully. In Stark's absence, Roose Bolton holds Harrenhal, which would seem to make him Lord of Harrenhal in practice, if not in name."
"Well, let him have it. The name suits our purposes far more than that useless pile of rubble. The Lord of Harrenhal will make a worthy suitor for the Widow Arryn."
"For which I am extremely grateful to you, my lord. Lady Arryn and I have known each other since we were children. She has always been positively predisposed toward me."
"A successful courtship would make Lord Baelish acting Lord of the Vale."
"Titles do seem to breed titles."
"You'll leave for the Eyrie as soon as possible and bring Lyta Arryn into the fold. Then the young wolf can add his own aunt to the list of people who've taken up arms against him."
"Far be it from me to hinder true love, but Lord Baelish's absence would present certain problems. The royal wedding may end up being the most expensive event in living memory. Summer has ended. Hard days lie ahead. Not a good time to leave the Crown's finances unattended."
"Fully agreed. Which is why I'm naming you new Master of Coin."
"Master of Coin?"
"It would appear to be a position that best suits your talents."
"I'm quite good at spending money, but a lifetime of outrageous wealth hasn't taught me much about managing it."
"I have no doubt you will prove equal to this challenge."
"Hear, hear.